It is a very beautiful situation. You don't need to do anything, but you can do anything. Means you are free to act, but you did not act. Like some people now, they have got enough money. So they don't have to work for money. But if they feel like they are physically fit to do action. So if they do and if they don't like it or they don't enjoy it, they withdraw it. Means they have total freedom of doing action. Whereas for most of the people, job is what? They have to do it. To run the house, job has to be done. That is one situation. And some people, they don't have such situation. They do it, if they feel like they're doing, otherwise they need not do it. So wise person has got complete freedom. Activities can happen through his body, mind, sense complex, and still he remains unbound. So that freedom of a wise person through knowledge is called Jnana Karma Sannyasa. That is being talked about. So 18th shloka talked about what is the vision of a wise person? Karmani Akarma. When action is happening, still is appreciating actionless Atma. And he appreciates another fact that Anatma, body, mind, sense complex can never be free from action. Even temporarily, it may have some resting period, but it is not completely free from action. So Anatma can never be free from action and Atma is ever free from action. This fact is understood. That person is buddhiman, intelligent, and that person is fulfilled. And then in the ninth shloka, what is his approach? That was told that his all initiatives, kama sankalpa varjitaha, are free from any desire or any fancy. You have seen kama and sankalpa. Sankalpa means fancy. How nice it is. If it is there, life becomes better. That is for sankalpa. Kama means I want it. So sankalpa leads to kama. So wise persons, all initiative are free from kama and sankalpa. And nanagdi dagdha karma. His all actions are burned by the knowledge. What is the knowledge? I am actionless self. Even though activities are happening in anatma, I am actionless self. We must remember this is not an escapism. It is not that, oh, so many wrong things I am doing, so I will say I am actionless. So to escape from responsibility, you say I am actionless. Like that person who was taken to the court for stealing, he said, I did not do, only my body did. Body only did stealing, I did not do. Because judge asked, why did you do this? I did not. Judge also has studied Vedanta. He said, I am not sending you to the jail. I am sending your body to the jail. Tit for tat. So this is not escapism. It is an appreciation of the fact that I am actionless self, I am free from all action. And to such a person, these learned people call a wise person. Means such a person whose activities are free from kama sankalpa, and whose all actions are burnt by the fire of knowledge, such a person is a wise person. Such a person is called wise person by learned people. So we saw in the last class. So whatever title you are giving to yourself, are they given by yourself or given by others? That is important. Otherwise you may say, I am expert in computer, I am expert in all language, Swamiji. So, you may say, but who is certifying you? That matters. So, therefore, here says, panditaha tam panditam, buddhaha tam panditam. So, wise person is the one who is free from sankalpa and kama, and he has got the fire of wisdom by which all karmas are burnt. And burnt karmas are burnt means karmas do not create punya papa for him. Karma does not create any guilt in him. Generally, people have got guilt that I did not do well, I could have done better, I did a wrong thing. In fact, every doctor can have guilt that, see, I did this mistake, patient suffered. They don't admit generally, but he once or twice must have happened. No doctor can say that I never committed any mistake. Can any doctor say? I cannot say that I gave all the lectures without any mistake. I also might have committed mistake. I also agree. It is arrogant to say that I never go wrong. Instead, in medical field, they say that some doctors, when they become very successful, they become so arrogant that they cannot listen to anybody's suggestion. So, assistant doctor will say, sir, this is happening. Keep quiet. So, assistant doctor is right, but he will not listen to it. Why? Because I am a senior surgeon and a patient may suffer. So, that is arrogance. Nobody can have arrogance that I cannot go wrong. Sachin Tendulkar also gets out for zero. Virat Kohli also gets out for zero. Possible? So, nobody should have that I cannot go wrong. It's an arrogance. So, there should not be any title assumption. I am. Who is giving you title? So, never have this arrogance of any doing anything perfect. So, you will be imperfect. And therefore, guilt may be there. But a wise person does not have guilt. It is not that wise person does not commit mistake. When wise person is doing, suppose wise person is a doctor. Will he commit mistake or not? Wise person also will commit a mistake. It's possible. When wise person is giving a talk, will he have a slip of tongue or not? Possible. Or he can give the meaning, this is a second case, third case, he can commit some mistake. Committing mistake is not completely gone. Is reduced because of his alertness. But based on the mistake, he or she will not have guilt. He said it happened. During that particular time, the background of the body was such, mind was such, that this can happen, it happened. So, wise person is free from the bondage of the karma. In terms of punya papa, he is free from this bondage and he is free from guilt. And now, Bhagavan Sri Krishna wants to say there are two varieties of wise people. Some wise people are remaining in Grihastha Ashrama and their wisdom continues. And some people are sannyasi and they are wise people. So, two types of wise people, Grihastha wise people and sannyasi wise people. Now, which one is superior? Grihastha wise person is superior or as a sannyasi wise person? It depends. Some people will say, no, sannyasi wise person is superior. People have value, no? So if a grihastha wise person is teaching, some people will not go. And some people say grihastha wise person is better. Why? Because in spite of remaining in grihastha ashrama, still is maintaining wisdom. So he deserves extra congratulations. This sannyasi is not doing anything and is a wise person. What a big thing. So it depends. People may say like this. But the vision of Bhagavan Sri Krishna is in the wisdom of wise people there is no difference. Why? Because in the vision of a wise person, little karma, sannyasi also will be doing small karma. He will be eating or not, going for bhiksha or not, taking bath or not. He will be doing. So, sannyasi is doing little karma and grihasthas are doing more karma. Now, sannyasi who is doing minimum karma, he will be seeing, I am a karta with reference to minimum activities. Sannyasi is seeing what? I am a karta with reference to many activities. Activities are mithya, I am satyam. So, this vision is there with reference to small activities and big activities. It doesn't make difference. Whether you saw a small dream or a big dream, which dream is mithya? Both are mithya. So, you saw in the dream that for 1 year you were the king of one kingdom in one dream. Another dream you saw that you were king only for 1 day. Now, your 1 day kingdom is real her 1 year kingdom is real. Both are unreal. So as far as the unreality is concerned, there is no difference. So when we have to dismiss, whether it is a 5 minute movie or 3 hour movie, both are mithya. You cannot say that a 3 hour movie has to be satya. So wise person, whether is in a grihastha ashrama setup or is in sannyasa setup, as far as the wisdom is concerned, there is no difference whatsoever. And of course, Bhagavan Shankaracharya says, generally wise people will become sannyasi because there is no purpose for activities and therefore they generally become sannyasi. But it is not necessary. Just because person is staying in the grihastha ashrama, therefore he cannot be a wise person, that is not correct. Other way also it is not correct. That just because somebody is a sannyasi, therefore he must be a wise person, that also is not correct. Just because person is a sannyasi, therefore he must be a wise person, not correct. Just because he is a grihastha, therefore he should not be a wise person, not correct. And if a person is sannyasi, he can be a wise person. Person is a grihastha, he can be a wise person. So in our mind, we should separate these two things, ashrama and wisdom. They are two different things. No particular ashrama is a guarantee for wisdom. No particular ashrama is the, what is called, remover of the possibility of wisdom. You cannot say that sannyasi, therefore he cannot be a wise person. He is a grihastha, cannot be a wise person. That is not that. That idea Bhagavan is giving. So he presents two varieties of wise people. And in the 20th shloka, he presents the grihasthashrami wise person. The wise person who is busy with so many activities. That is given in the 20th shloka. Tyaktva karma phala sangam.
Tyaktva karma phala sangam.
Nityatripto nirashrayah.
Nityatripto nirashrayah.
Karmanya vipravruttopi.
Karmanya vipravruttopi.
Naiva kinchit karoti sah.
Naiva kinchit karoti sah.
So he describes this wise person who happens to be in the setup of grihasthashrama. So he says, this wise person is what? Nitya Trupta. He is ever satisfied with himself. This is the biggest benefit of self-knowledge. You are satisfied with yourself. Ever satisfied. Samsara is what? Being dissatisfied with yourself. I am not okay. I want to become somebody. I am only a clerk. I want to become a manager. Then from manager, I want to become assistant general manager. Then general manager. Then assistant vice president. They want vice president, also assistant vice president. You know, assistant vice president. I said, vice itself has got the idea of assistant. But you know, in the psychology, they want to use the title. So they give so many, 5-6 people will be assistant vice president. Okay, assistant vice president, then vice president, then president. Then only one company president. I would like to become the president of so many companies. There is no end. No. Wisdom gives you satisfaction with yourself. Whether money is there or money is not there, I am satisfied. Whether people are there around, not there, I am satisfied. Whether students are coming to learn, satisfied. Not coming, satisfied. That is nitya. The other way, some people, you know, some Swamis, they are dependent upon the students. One Swami was telling that you organize my classes, otherwise I will go crazy. Okay, Swami. That is unfortunate. Nitya Truptaha means people are there. If people are there, it is not I am disturbed. But people are not there, I don't feel lonely. That is the biggest advantage of wisdom. Ever satisfied with oneself. Nitya Truptaha. Nirakamshaha Visheshu. There is no any desire that this setup should happen for my satisfaction. And nirashraya. Nirashraya means, actually nirashraya means supportless. Generally nirashraya can be a description of a helpless person who he doesn't have any support. But this is a greatness of a wise person. What? He doesn't have any support. But he doesn't have support is not a helpless situation. It is the indicatory of his freedom. See, if you need support and you don't have support, it is a miserable condition. You need support and you don't have support. Miserable condition. You don't need support and you don't have support. Is there a problem? See, all of us are walking without crutches. You know crutches, you know that paisa ki bolte. So, you all of us are walking without crutches. You don't bring crutches. Are you feeling miserable about it? Oh, I don't have crutches. You don't feel. Why? You don't need it. You don't need crutches and you don't have crutches. Is there a problem? You need and somebody took away. You need crutches and somebody took away. Miserable situation. So the wise person is the one who doesn't need any support, whether they are there or not. And here when we say he doesn't need support, what we mean is emotional support. Physical support he may need. If he falls sick, he may require somebody to take him to the bathroom. That also may be required. Physical support is required. But if physical support is not there, he doesn't have the feeling of helplessness. Most of the people who become old, they have got this problem. When they need somebody and somebody doesn't come in time, then they feel very emotionally so disturbed. I called you and you did not come. That fellow came after 15-20 minutes. No, I don't want. React. I called you 5 minutes back, you didn't come. 15 minutes back I called you. Why you took so much time? You don't care for me. I don't want your help. This is emotional dependence. Emotional reaction. Wise person, what will he do? He calls. If he physically needs, he'll call. If it doesn't happen, then he will wait for the person. When he comes, he takes him. If he doesn't come, he will try to manage. And if he can't manage, he let go situation. Whatever happens, happens. So, nirashrayaha means emotional dependencies. Many people say, Swamiji, we don't need any financial support or even physical support from our children. But we always want them to call us. Always we want them to be in touch with us. They should call us regularly. Moral support they call. Moral support. That is called ashraya. Emotional support. They call moral support is emotional support. If you require some physically, you require help and you ask for nothing wrong. Even wise person ask for help. Asking for help, physical help or even financial help when needed, nothing wrong in it. But emotional, like some men they say, it is not enough that you cook, that lady has to serve the food also. Not only cooking. She's there on the table, why don't you take? No. I want her to serve. That is emotional. Physical support, yes, I don't know how to cook. So therefore I need somebody and she cooks well, so it's okay. That's so you depend upon her, is okay. But no, she has to go somewhere, but no, my husband has to eat that time and so somehow she has to come, so she is so tense. That is emotional dependence. And so nirashrayaha means he does not have dependence upon anyone for his emotional well-being. Sense of fulfillment. That is not there. Oh, people say, Swamiji, without that person, my life is zero. That is emotional dependence. Yeah, you have financial difficulty and therefore you suffer and you require help, it is okay. But without that person, my life is zero. That is not there. Nirashraya. That is why in olden days they used to say that once in a while you go to Ekanta, solitary. Vivikta Desha Sevitva. See how much emotional independence we have. Yes, Swamiji, I will do it. I will take my mobile, so I will be in touch with them. That's independent. Somebody was asked, that, how did you manage this 1 year bhavanam? Is it through SMS? Then also okay. But no, without that, can we just remain by ourselves? Once in a while, one should try this. Because you may think that, no, Swami, I am not dependent on anybody. I can manage without money. When it happens, you know, really you are able to manage. Alright, so Dhyashayaha. Then, such a person, karma phala sangam tyakta. Having given up, tyakta means having given up, asanga, attachment to karma and phala. Karma sakti, phala sakti. What is karma sakti? I should do this karma. Without this particular activity, how can I live? Some people know, especially these people, those who have been in higher position, they were IS officer, you know, collector, secretary, etc. So when that they are retired, for them it is a big vacuum. Because next day, what will I do? I ring the bell and nobody comes here. Why is that? What is that? Every day she used to serve me food on time because I have to go to the office. Today she will say, you don't have to go to the office. Karma. So, value is down. So, there is a asakti for karma. There is a value to look occupied. To be occupied. So people will ask that after retirement, what are you doing? So something they say, consultancy. It's a very good word. Consultancy. Nothing doing. Consultancy. I do pre-consultancy. How many people come? Nobody comes, but I am doing it. I am trying to do it. That is karma. Means attachment to karma. Not having the ability to remain without particular duties. Particular work. They want some work to be done which is in limelight. If wife says you cut the vegetable down, that I would want. That also is a work. But that he doesn't want. He wants only some limelight work. Karma sakti. Other is phala sakti. The attachment for particular result. I want this. I want a particular gadget. I want particular bungalow. I want particular trip. Otherwise, what is the life? So, phala sakti. I want a particular result of action. Wise person is free from that. He is not particular about any action. He is doing something and somebody says, Swamiji, you need not do it. Okay, you do it. Whereas, this samsari, if some action is taken away from him, he will be so disturbed. Suppose he is doing some seva to Swamiji. And other person comes and Swamiji thinks that let other person do it because this person is senior and finding difficult. So he gives to other person, immediately the first person is so disturbed. Why Swamiji, have I done anything wrong? Why you are taking away from me? What will I do? I want to do it. That is called this karma sakti philosophy. Wise person, karma sakti. Wise person says, I will do if it is to be done. If it is not to be done, not required to be done, I am okay without it. That is called being free from karma. Ready to do, but ready to let go of any action. Phala sakti means, he is doing some action and he does not give particular result. He will say, okay, I am not particular. It is to be done, therefore I am doing. Whatever be the result, if it doesn't come, it doesn't matter. I am already purna. I am already infinite. To infinite, anything you add will be infinite only. My Purnatvam cannot be improved upon. Therefore, karma phala sangam tyaktva. What a freedom it is. You do if it is to be done. And if it is not to be done, you are ready to let it. And you are not particular about any result. If this happens, fine, it doesn't happen. That is karma phala samyamchaktva. Karmani abhipravrutta. Even though he is engaged in various actions, still, naiva kinchit karoti saha. He does not do any action. So two contradictory things are said. Even though he is busy with action, he does not do action. How can it be so? He is busy with action, he is doing the action. Bhagavan Sri Krishna says, busy with action but does not do action. So, karmani abhi pravruttaha agnani drishtya. From the standpoint of an ignorant person who is looking upon the wise person's body, mind, sense complex, he will say, this Swamiji is so busy, more busy than even the CEO of the company, very busy. Or this wise person, he happens to be the king, so busy. But from his standpoint, the standpoint of a wise person, naiva kinchit karoti. He does not do anything. In his wisdom, I do not do anything. So, agnani drishtya, karmani abhipravrutta, engaged in action. Jnani drishtya, naiva kinchit karoti. So, that is his wisdom. That is his freedom. In spite of being busy with action, from his standpoint, he is not doing any action. So this is the grihastha-ashrama variety, the wise person obtaining in grihastha-ashrama. Now in the next shloka, the sannyasi jnani is described. Nirashiryata chittatma
Tyakta-sarva-parigraha
Shariram-kevalam-karma Kurvannapnoti-kilvisham Now other variety, sannyasa. There are two possibilities. In our Shastra, they talk about four ashramas. Brahmacharya, Grihastha-ashrama, Vanaprastha and Sannyasa. General order is Brahmacharya Grihi Bhavet, Grihi Bhutva Vani Bhavet, Vani Bhutva Prabhavet. This is a default setting, regular setting. First person starts students like Brahmacharya-ashrama. Then after Brahmacharya-ashrama, with the permission of the Acharya, he enters into Grihastha. That is our convention. That is why now also some family write, by the blessings of this our Acharya, this our son is getting married. In olden days, this what a nice system. That Acharya will send the person to Grihastha Ashrama when he is bachelor. See, nowadays for driving license, you require a license. For flying, you require a license. For Grihastha Ashrama, no license required. In those days, Acharya used to certify that, yes, now this person is ready to grow into Grihastha. Then he is allowed to do this particular snana. That is why graduate is called snataka. Snataka means one who has done special snanam, which is marking the completion of Brahmacharya. So a particular snanam is done, where all his big hair and all this will be shaved up. So then particular snanam is done. And after that snanam, he is fit to enter into Grihastha. So a nice system. So his guru will certify that this person will not be a burden to the society. Otherwise he is retained in the gurukula. 1 year more, 2 year more, 3 year more, then only he will be allowed. So that we will have good grihasthas. So after the permission of the Acharya, the person enters into grihasthashrama. And in grihasthashrama, he follows the sadhana of karma yoga. He does listen to Vedanta, but the main sadhana is karma yoga. And then after some 20-25 years, his children are adult, mature, and at home. Nowadays that is not happening. Because this fellow himself is getting married at the age of 35. So when he is 50-55, his son is hardly 18-20. not settled. And therefore, he has to wait till, generally convention is that till son gets married, person remains in Grihastashram. Then he goes to Vanaprastha. So, if I wait for my son to get married, I will be die only. So, many people have this problem. But I am telling the general convention. So, by the age of 50-55, the son, daughter, they are adult, mature, they are getting married, and they hand over the responsibility. Then they go to the forest, or they can remain in the outhouse of the property. Means that some separate cottage will be there, and their husband and wife can remain together at Vanaprasthashrama. And Vanaprasthashrama is Upasana Pradhana, Tapa Pradhana. More and more fasting should be done. Maunam should be kept. And many of the bhogas to be dropped. So more tapas. So minimum the bhoga. And maximum upasana. More and more japa should be done. More and more meditation on Ishvara should be done. Upasana. And then after few years remaining in that, that becomes a training for next ashram. Sannyasa ashram. Then this person takes sannyasa. For a lady, it becomes sannyasa. When a man takes sannyasa, automatically it becomes sannyasa for her. So, this is the last ashram is sannyasa. So, the default order is brahmacharya grihi bhavet. After brahmacharya ashram, one should become householder. Gruhat vani bhavet. Grihi bhutva vani bhavet. Then he should become vanaprastha. And vani bhutva pravajit. And then he should take sannyasa. This is a normal setting. But optional is there. Yadiva itaratha. Or optionally, brahmacharya deva pravraje. From brahmacharya ashram itself, one can go to sannyasa. Bypass. Like we do not sometimes bypass road, so this will be the bypass road. What? From brahmacharya, jumping these two ashrama, grihastashrama and vanaprastha, directly enters into sannyasa. And, or grihadva vanan. Or from Grihastashrama, directly one can go to Sannyasa, one can skip Vanaprastha. Or Grihat, then Vanaprastha, and then Sannyasa. So all these options are there. It can be the ashram number 4, it can be ashram number 2, or it can be ashram number 2. Sannyasa can be ashram number 4 when person has gone all 3. Or it can be ashram number 2 when Brahmacharya to Sannyasa directly has gone. Or Brahmacharya Grihastha and then going to sannyasa. So ashram number 3 it can become. Or it can become 4. So all possibilities are there. But the wise person who is referred to here is a sannyasa. And traditionally, sannyasi will not be busy with any extra activities. Sannyasi will be doing minimum activities of this maintaining the body, diksha, snanadi, bas. That much karma only will be. So, karma required for the maintenance of the body is called shariram karma. Shariram karma means action for the maintenance of the body. Like going to bhiksha, correcting bhiksha. We are talking about sannyasa. Shariram karma is doing. And by doing shariram karma, he is not getting any papam. In that minimum karma also, if any himsa or something is involved, he will not get any power. That is the message. That wise person, if he is a sannyasi, if he does minimum karma, he does not get any pratyavaya, any vipapam because of not doing the duties. If a sannyasi does not do any charity work, then he does not get papam. If sannyasi does not do sandhya vandanam, he doesn't get papam. If he doesn't go to the temple, doesn't get power. Why? He has been given exemption by Shastra. For what? For remaining committed to Brahmajnana. He should do Shastra Shravana Manana Nidhyasa. That he should not deviate from. If he is a wise person, he need not do. But if he is not a wise person, every sannyasi should be committed to the study of Shastra, contemplation of Shastra. That is his main occupation. any other thing if he doesn't do, it is okay. So here we are talking about sannyasi who is doing minimum karma. Shariram karma kurvan, doing minimum karma. But what is his mindset? Nirashihi, does not have any expectation from anyone. This is a very important thing to know. If you want to be free from activities, you have to reduce your expectation from others. If you are having expectation from others, you have to contribute. If I want people to serve me, then I have to pay salary, and for paying salary I have to work. So these two things go together. If I want to reduce my activity, I have to reduce my expectations. People have this particular problem because their expectations are not reduced, but the activities they want to reduce. I don't want to work for it, but I want the benefit of it. Then there is a conflict. So, Nirashihi means he does not expect anything from it. Nirasha. And Yata Chittatma, even though he is exempted from all the duties, but he does not use his freedom for doing wrong action. Therefore, say Yata Chittatma means Atma here is body, mind and body are well disciplined. The wise person is the one whose mind and body are well disciplined. Even though he is free to do anything, but he will not do anything. Like president and all, they have got immunity, legal immunity. But we expect that president will not require immunity. They will not behave. So, wise person is naturally doing what is to be done and naturally avoids what is not to be done. Therefore, Yata Chittatma means mastery over the body and the mind. And Tyakta Sarva Parigraha. This is a description of sannyasa. Tyakta Sarva Parigraha means he has given up all possessions. Sannyasi and possessions go together, don't go together. Nowadays it is opposite. Sannyasi will have more luggage than grihastha. That's what is happening. Grihastha will be one bag. Sannyasi will have 3-4 bags. He requires this for this, this for this, this for this. Sarva parigraha. This is classical sannyasi is described, not modern sannyasi. Tyakta sarva parigraha. One who is free from all possessions. Then only he can be free from this duties. You are keeping so much possession, then what? You have to do the activities. Simple thing, if you have got the parigraha of some sweet, you know, in dining hall some sweet over there, and you liked it very much, so you took one extra and brought it to your room. You have to do the, you have to do protection, ants will come. So you have to bring some plate, in that you put some water, in that you put some bowl, and in that you put sweet. So much you have to do. And by chance you forget, then all water is gone, ants will come. So even a small thing you see, how much protection is required. So this sannyasi wise person, Tyakta Sarva Parigraha. More inner security you are feeling, more you will be free from possession. Generally, possessiveness comes because of inner sense of insecurity. And this wise person is free from that, Tyakta Sarva Parigraha. And such a wise person, Shariram Karma Kurvan, doing minimum karma meant for the maintenance of the body. That also Kevalam. Kevalam means without identification. Even when he is going for Bhiksha, which is a minimum karma for the maintenance of the body, he does not have Abhimana. I am going for Bhiksha. Why should I go for Bhiksha? How long I have to go for Bhiksha? That type of thought is not. It is the prarabdha of the body that it will have this minimum activities. I am the sakshi of this body which is going for Bhiksha. Doesn't have the kartrutvam even for that minimum activities. And such a person, kilbisham na apnoti, he does not get any power. In the minimum activities, if any hinsa, any violence is involved, then he will not get power. Why? Kartrutvam is not. And here Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, he does not get even punyam. Does not get papam, does not get even punyam. Why? Because he doesn't have ahankar. Punyam, papam are there when there is a kartrutva, that I am doing the activities. So I am doing the activities, that ahankara, that identification, that ego, is responsible for creating punyam. This wise person is free from that. So he does not get punyam, does not get papam. And people may say, Swamiji, that's not fair. No? He may not get papam is a very good thing, but at least he should get punyam. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, dharmaha api mumukshoho kilbisham eva. From the highest standpoint, even punyam is like papam. Why? Like papa. Not papa. Like papa. Why? Just as papa binds the person and keeps in samsara, punyam also keeps the person in samsara. If you have got punya, then you will get higher janma. Samsara only. It is something like somebody is given, put in jail, but A grade, he is kept in A grade. You know, there is, in jail also there are grades. A, B, C. Jail only. Or this person, he is tied, but not with the iron shekel, golden shekel. Golden shekel is shekel only. Golden chain, you are still tied. Like in our countries, one royal family member was to be beheaded. So they used the golden sword to just behead. That's all. Greatness is that much only. That golden sword, he was beheaded. Beheading is safe. So from the ultimate standpoint, from the sadhaka, mumukshu standpoint, punyam is required. He always say you earn more punyam. But from the ultimate standpoint, punyam and papam, both are similar. Why? Bandhaka padakatvar. Because both of them are binding. So our Shastra's approach is, initially you reduce papa and increase punyam. Shastras initially, that Shastra will say, you reduce and avoid papam and earn more and more punya. And by this approach, reduction of papa and increase of punya, you will get the opportunity to study Shastra, you get dhanam. And when you get dhanam, then you transcend punya and papa both. Moksha does not mean maximum punya. Moksha means being free from punyam and papa both. So therefore, here kilbisham is papam, but it also implies punyam. A wise person does not get punyam, does not get papam. If you have got greed for punyam, you cannot avoid papam. You cannot say, no, Swamiji, I would like to always collect punyam, but papa I should be exempted. That is not possible. Many people do like this. See, if things go well, they say, what? I did it. Things doesn't go well, somebody did. That is a usual thing. Therefore, there is a saying in English. Success has got many fathers, failure has got none. Failure doesn't, nobody claims. Let's see, it is because of my mistake, this happened. Nobody claims. In fact, when you say, who did it? Everybody keeps quiet. If everything goes well, I did it. So many people will claim, because of me it happened. So, wise person does not claim either of them. Neither claims success, failure, neither claims punyam nor papam. He is free from the need for punya papam, and he is free from the basis for punya papam, which is kartrutvam. So, he doesn't have sense of doership, therefore, no punya papam. And how this wise person will be leading his life if he does not have any means for livelihood? How will he live his life? For that answer is given, यदृच्छालाभसन्तुष्टः द्वन्द्वातीतो विमत्सरः समसिद्धावसिद्धौ च कृत्वापि न निबध्यते in the previous shloka that wise person who is sannyasi was described. What is the indicator that is a description of sannyasi? Tyakta sarva parigraha. He is free from any possession. And that is only for a sannyasi. Grihasthas is allowed to have possessions. Why? They are supposed to do their duties. They are supposed to cook for themselves. They should not go for bhiksha. So if they also go for bhiksha, we will give bhiksha. So they have to cook for themselves, they have to cook for others. And I tell you, cooking means so many things are required. To make some two rotis, how many things are required? Those who know, they know. This man thinks that, see, why is he asking so many things? Only he says, give me roti sabji. To make roti sabji, so many things are required. So many dabbas will be required. this is what is called this chili is there, salt is there, cardamom is there. So many things are required. So, tyakta sarva parigraha means sannyasa. It is a good thing for grihasthas to know that grihasthas are allowed to have parigraha. But they should have parigraha which they can manage. Sometimes they have got so much accumulation that they have to sleep outside. The room is full of things. That type of parigraha should not be there. You keep things which are required. So sannyasi doesn't have parigraha, then how will he manage his life? For that answer is given. Yadricha labha santushta. It's a very beautiful word, especially for sadhaka, and that too, sannyasi sadhaka, more important. Grihastha is also very useful. It's a very beautiful word. It describes the frame of a mind of a wise person. And anybody who wants to be a wise person also is a useful word. What is that? Santushtaha means satisfied. Yadricha labha. Yadricha labha means the attainment by yadricha without demanding, based on prarabdha. So yadricha means prarabdha. So happy, santushtaha, satisfied with the gain as per prarabdha. So especially as a wise person, he does not demand. He, when he goes for bhiksha, he doesn't say, give me bhiksha for idli vada dosa. He should ask only bhiksha. He should not say, give me bhiksha of dosa, masala dosa. Every day you are simply giving dosa. He cannot, he's not supposed to ask. People sometimes ask me, Swami, you are coming for bhiksha, what will you eat? I said, I am not supposed to tell. Maximum I can tell is that this item doesn't suit me. That much I can tell. But somehow people directly, indirectly, dhamma also, this is okay. But as a sannyasi, we are not supposed to say, make this. One person is a Gujarati Samaj, at one restaurant, one who runs restaurant. He told me, he came and told me, Swamiji, whenever you feel like eating some item, you just tell me. I said, Swamiji, I will give parcel. You just, when you are passing by and you feel like eating, I said, yes, for ashram, if something is to be made, I will call it. But for me, if I even am passing by, I will say, oh, for so many days I had not eaten this dal-dokli, so I will go and have this. That is not, sannyasi is not supposed to do that. Sannyasi doesn't have to ask for. You do this and do that. If that he wants, Swamiji, I am sannyasi, but I like to have this item morning, evening. Then it could not become sannyasi. So if you are thinking, some of you, I am telling you. So if you want to become a sannyasi, First of all, you should be ready. And Swamiji, with the coffee, what will happen? You should be ready without the coffee. Swamiji, this, I always want this Sair Sadam has to be there for me. You should be free from that demand. South Indian, you cannot think that this meal is complete without Sair Sadam. You should be ready for that. Yadritcha Labhasa. Whatever comes in Dicha, and even a grihastha needs to develop this attitude. I generally tell this. When you sit on your dining table, whatever food comes, eat without complaints. And today, suppose salt is less, don't add. It is at much cooler. If you eat without salt, you are not going to die. Isn't it? If more salt, perhaps, if you have got some BP and perhaps something may happen. The person doesn't die, no? That person dies. If a person has got BP problem and he eats this food with more salt, he will not die. The doctor is there, so I can. If I say a person dies, then I will be in trouble. So I have a doctor to ask. So, at least have that attitude. Don't add from outside. Just eat. At least you start your Yadritcha Labha Santushta with this. Don't say that, why did you make this item? Why didn't you make this item? At least this much you practice. Yadritcha Labha Santushta. Don't ask for this, you make this or you make this. Whatever she makes, Yadritcha Labha Santushta. Because Swamiji are already practicing this. She never asked me, so. Anyway, but not only this food, in general everything. So, sometimes this, it is hot and fan is not there. Only fan is there, AC is not there. And I tell you one thing, that you have more capacity to handle this heat and cold than you think you have. You think that what will happen, but you remain in this hot, you manage. You see, in hot season people are working or not. They are also human beings. So, you have more capacity than you think. So, we underestimate sometimes. I don't say that in hot season you should go out, if you are not used to, you should not. But if this 5 minutes fan is not there, just be patient. Some people shout and all this. Learn. It's even small situation in life. Our growth happens by small baby steps. So you ask yourself that how many times during the day I have to complain. Reduce your number. How many times you complain? Yeah, if something is your duty and so to be done, then you do it. You have to complain. Complaining is your duty, you do it. But otherwise, in general, Yadritcha Labha Santushta. If people are there to set up, that's fine. Not there, no, nobody is there. If somebody will come, something do it. Oh, I myself have to do it, I'll do it. Yadritcha Labha Santushta. It's a very beautiful attitude. That makes you a saintly person. Whether you are in Grihasthashrama or you are a sannyasi. Is Yadritcha Labha Santushta attitude you have, you are a saint. Saintly person is the one who does not complain. Whatever happens, he is happy with that. Oh, see?